Good day, welcome to Scholars in Russell School online classes for Islamic science. Today we'll be having biology. Under biology, we'll be discussing our tolerance and adaptation. So, we started at adaptation of animals to aquatic habitats. So, and today we're looking at adaptation of animals to terrestrial habitats. The first adaptive feature is they possess powerful limbs for movement. They possess lungs, possession of lungs for gaseous exchange. Instead of gills, animals in aquatic habitat use gills. So the terrestrial animals use lungs for their gaseous exchange. Possession of sweat glands for excretion. Possession of air as a mammal and that of feathers as a bird for better temperature regulation. So the air in mammals, which include the human being, are used to regulate their temperature. White feathers also are used in temperature regulation. Possession of skin as in mammals and cortical by insects is to protect and prevent drying up and injury. So the skin in mammals and the cortical in insects, they are used they both protect and prevent drying up and injury. Adaptation of animals to arboreal habitats. So, these arboreal habitats include animals that live in air and those that live in very tall trees. Possession of wings for flight. So, the birds, they possess wings for flight. Possession of hollow bones to make them light, e.g. birds. So, the bones present in birds are hollow. This is to make them light in air so that they can be able for easy flying. Possession of bright colors as well as camouflage. So the animals in the arboreal habitat are very bright colored. So this bright coloration is for their camouflage. That means they hide from either their prey or their predator. So they mix with the environment they are in. So in order for them not to be detected by their prey or their predator. Possession of powerful limbs, claws, and tails for climbing and piercing. For example, the monkey, they have a prehensile tail which they can use to climb, and they have claws which they use to pierce trees, and their limbs are powerful enough for them to climb tall the trees. Possession of streamlined body for easy flight. So the birds, they possess a streamlined body to prevent friction between their body and air so that they can fly easily. Possession of strong muscles and tendons to ease flight. Feed mainly on grains to provide energy required for flight. So the arboreal animals, they feed mainly on grains to provide energy. The grains are very high in carbohydrates, so this will provide energy needed for their flight. Plant adaptation. Adaptation of plants to aquatic habitat. So I've looked at the adaptation of animals to the aquatic and terrestrial habitat. Now let's look at the adaptation of plants to the aquatic habitat. So they possess waxy cortical on leaves to prevent wilting. They possess long stem and flower stalks to expose the leaves and the flowers and leaves. The aquatic plants, they are above, their leaves and flowers are above the water for them to be able to tap sunlight available. This is sunlight available. So their stem and their flower stalk would be long to expose the leaves to provide food for the plants. Possession of adventures, their roots are scattered, so on inside the soil, the root is going to be scattered to in order for them to gain nutrients available. Possession of air flows of leaves and stem for buoyancy. So buoyancy means that they can easily float on water, so they have air flows in their leaves and their stems. Possession of breeding room for gaseous exchange. These are common in the mangrove swamp. They possess breeding rooms, which is known as pneumatophore, for their gaseous exchange. Possession of air spaces in tissues for buoyancy. So air spaces are present in their tissues for them to be able to float on water. Note, plants that live successfully in water or that live successfully in an aquatic habitat are called hydrophytes. adaptation of annual plants to terrestrial habitats. So these terrestrial habitats in Ireland to have those that live on the desert and those that live among us. One, possession of extensive root system for anchorage and water absorption. Possession of thick bags on stems to protect internal tissues. Their bags are very thick to protect the internal tissues that overflow and design them. Possession of numerous leaves to enhance better photosynthesis. Possession of succulent stems by desert plants to store excess water. So, plants in the desert, they have succulent stems to store excess water because water is scarce in the desert. Still on the adaptation of plants to terrestrial habitat, the desert plant possess tiny and scanty leaves to reduce water loss through transpiration. Transpiration is the loss of water from a plant, is the loss of water as vapor from a plant. So they do that in order to reduce, they have tiny and scanty leaves in order for them to reduce their water loss. Possession of thick quartz corticals on leaves to prevent water loss through transpiration. So they also possess thick quartz corticals on their leaves to prevent water loss through transpiration. Note, plants that can survive in extremely dry places or deserts are called xerophytes, while those who live in not too dry or not too wet are called mesophytes. So the ones that we see in our surroundings are the mesophytes, while those that they are that they can survive in extreme dry places are known as xerophytes. Now let's look at special adaptation of some organisms. Adaptation of tilapia fish for movement. So this is a tilapia fish diagram. So now let's look at how this tilapia fish adapts itself to move for movement. Possession of fins for movement in water. Possession of streamlined body for easy movement. Possession of lateral line for detection of vibration of water. Possession of powerful tail which is used to propel the fish forward. The powerful tail is used to drive the fish forward in water. This lateral system is used to detect, it will allow the fish to know if a prey or predator is present in the water. So, still on the adaptation of tilapia fish for movement. The direction of the fins and scales backwards to aid movement through water. So as the fish is moving forward through water, the fins and scales will be moving opposite to the direction of the fish in order for it to be moving, in order for it to move easily through water. Possession of light eyes without eyes which enable it to see predators and prey easily. So they have light eyes without eyes which enable them to see predators and prey easily. Possession of swim bladder which aids buoyancy. So they have swim bladder which allows them to float in water. The silvery white color of the body below and the black above prevents from being seen by enemies. So if you see any tilapia fish, you see that the body is somehow white and the top is somehow black. The silvery white color of the body below is just for it to me. In the ocean, if you are looking at it from the bottom to the top, that silvery white color will be like as if you are seeing the sky, but it's the fish, so that the fish is able to be not detected from below. And above, if you are looking at the sea, it looks dark, so the black color above would prevent an enemy above from taking it. So we look at the adaptation of the tilapia fish, and let's look at the adaptation of chameleon. Possession of long sticky tongue which is used for capturing prey. Possession of claws on the feet used for holding objects on which it walks. Ability to change the color of the body in order to hide from the predator or enemies. The other chameleon, they change the color of their body in order to hide from their predators or enemies. This would, wherever surroundings they are, they change their colors to the color of their surroundings, which make it undetected by the predator. Possession of powerful eyes which enable it to see prey and predators easily. So the eyes are so powerful they can see their prey and their predators easily. So that's all we're going to stop the class for today. Thanks for watching. To meet in the next class, so we'll be looking at more adaptive features of animals. Like and subscribe to this channel. And if you feel you have questions to ask, contact us on this WhatsApp number. And if you are looking for more information, visit our website www.classwhatsapp.com. Thanks for